It's Mental Health Awareness Month, and you're not alone if you're struggling with depression or PTSD. In fact, today we are joined by a woman who has been through both and found her purpose. Please welcome the show, empowerment expert and author, Dr. Sonia Stribling. Dr. Yes. Sonia, thank you for being here.
Honored to be here with all of you, for
sure. The honor is ours, for
absolutely.
Sure.
And before we get started, we did want to say, a lot of us have dads and family members in the military. Thank you for your 21 years of service.
Wow, so 21 years.
Wow, thank you for your support. It is definitely received well, so thank you so much for your support.
Well, let's get into it, because we have your book here. In your book, you talk about the life-changing traumas that led to your depression and PTSD. Can you tell us what those experiences were specifically?
Absolutely. Very young age, at 15, I had my first child, so I was a child raising a child, 17 years old. Sexual assault, let's just call it what it is. It was rape.
Yes.
And then shortly after that, that's really shaped my life. So that would be the first part of the post-traumatic stress disorder that I had to deal with from my childhood and things like that. And then later on, joining the United States military and serving my country for 21 years with 3 combat tours, and one was to Iraq. My body came home to my family 15 months after that, but my mind, my heart, and my spirit did not. And so I had to go through this roller coaster ride of just trying to figure out what was happening. And being a senior leader in the military was something, the status quo, you're not to talk about that. You're not to discuss that. And it does not happen to me, is the whole thing that I believe many of us go through, especially in the military.
Yeah, I would just think, as a leader, you're instructed not to display weakness. Like, you can't talk about things that you're a human being. But I do want to talk about the book title, From the Battlefield to the Boardroom. Talk to us about what that means and where you came up with that title.
This is 5 years in the making, honestly. It took 5 years just to get this out. And the battlefield is not just a physical war ground, a physical place. It's the things that have happened to us in our past. Maybe it was divorce. Mm-hmm. Maybe it was some trauma, drama, all of that. So that's our battlefield, because I believe we all have a battlefield. But when we go to the boardroom, a boardroom is not corporate America. It's not sitting at the boardroom table and having those business or the conversations about corporate life. The boardroom is our place where we decide where we get to the level of success in our life, in our career, and in our business.
Wow, I love talking to people like you that overcome things. I'm fascinated with it. You know what I mean? Because we have so many problems in today's society that I think are not anywhere near your problems. Not comparing the two, but anyways, something very sensitive. But you talk about it as well. You tried almost committing suicide.
Yes.
At one point.
Yes.
But you overcame that and became a successful entrepreneur. What steps did you take? Where did it start?
You know, when you ask me that, I'm smiling, and I know folks are like, you're not supposed to smile. I am, because I wasn't supposed to be here. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that I made a decision to do that I highly advise others, it was taking a step of where I was. And my prayer was, please, Lord, don't let me remain like this. I can't be another dead woman walking physically. Mm-hmm. And on the inside, just empty. And so I made a promise. You know, we make deals. So I made a deal. I said, if you would just allow me to make it through this and get to the next level of who I'm supposed to be, and I'm retired military at this point, I've served my country, if you would just let me do that, I would serve you with every part of my being. And that's what I did. So I stopped looking at me, mm-hmm. and what my problem was, because post-traumatic stress or PTSD was my new normal. And I start looking at who can I help through this process. And that's how I was able to build a highly successful $28 million company in 3 years from my heartache and my pain.
Wow. Oh, unbelievable.
I love it.
I mean, you say that there is a difference between powerful women and strong women.
Yes.
Tell us what that difference is.
Okay, so I get a little pushback a lot on social media about this comment. A strong woman to me is a woman that is going through the process, and she's not really coming out on the other side. She's just surviving. Mm. But when I say a powerful woman is going, she's enduring what she's going through, but she is thriving. Mm. There's a difference. Mm. And a lot of us, I was raised by a strong mom. I love my mother, bless her soul now, right? But I know I started to realize strong and powerful are two different people, and there are two different outcomes, and I wanted the better outcome for me and my children at that time.
I love that. I've told my mom that strong produces powerful, because when you can see it, and then you can have that extra ability to be it. That's a very strong and powerful statement.
It is, absolutely.
I love that. Oh my gosh. Thank you so much, Dr. Sonia. Everybody, here's her book, Let's see it. DBL Nation, you can go to drsoniabrands.com to get your copy of From the Battlefield to the Boardroom today. Thank you again.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We need you back here.
Yes. We need more time.
We need to get into that mind.
Yeah. Like, I just,
bracket open. By you.
Like that went so fast. Yeah. Whoa, that was it. Absolutely.
And we will be right back. Thank you again.